I would like to start by talking to Belarusians, since their current struggle is related to this video's idea. Белорусы, своей борьбой вы вызываете гордость у меня и у огромного множества других людей. Кое-где даже возвращаете нашу шаткую веру в человечество. Пусть раболепные лукашисты кидаются в вас словами сколько угодно, неважно. Ваши действия – это самозащита и защита близких. Самозащита не может быть неправильной, а наглухо обнаглевшим диктаторам точно не место в 21 веке. Жаль только, что этот режим паразитировал на вас целых 26 лет. В общем, я хоть и не в силах вам ощутимо помочь, но кулаки за вас держу. Крепитесь и не сдавайтесь. А те, кто на стороне власти, особенно грязное животное силовых структур, одумайтесь, пока не слишком поздно. Чем дальше в лес, тем острее гильотина. Живе Беларусь! With that said, let's get to the topic. It being the fact that the true purpose of government is to serve its people, not the other way around. After all, it is 2020, and things like feudalism and serfdom are no longer widely acceptable. I am not the property of my state. In fact, every government official and employee is working for me, since their salary is paid with my tax money. Let's get back to the base level. Imagine we live in a complete anarchy. What is the point of paying money and giving authority over yourself to some group of people? The point is to dramatically raise your own well-being by receiving services such as policing, national defense, healthcare, education, transportation, utilities, social safety nets, and more. In a properly governed society, human rights stop being mere ideas and start being protected by law. While the authority figures play the role of service providers who receive only the necessary resources to do their job. That's a government that serves its citizens, as it should do. But what if citizens serve the government? What if your government decides it's not going to guarantee some of your basic human rights? What if it decides you have to pay more and give up more freedoms for the same return, or even less? What if it forces you to serve in offensive wars against other governments? What if your representatives ignore your needs and instead blatantly serve the highest bidder? Are you still a citizen at this point? Or perhaps you're part of the livestock, property of a giant slave owner. You're not being served, you're being exploited. So here's a natural question. What's the fucking point? You might as well turn to anarchy with this kind of shitfuckery. Yes, you might get killed, but at least you make your own rules. Unfortunately, many modern governments in the developed world are exploitative. And of course, most of us wouldn't even consider anarchist uprising, which is why it's important for people to at least not have a slave's mentality and to fight for their interests within the existing systems. To me, it's a tragic sight when people in the US, Russia, North Korea, and elsewhere blindly follow their politicians like those are god emperors from the Warhammer 40K. At the end of the day, we only have one life, and we can't afford to waste it on being a slave.
Thanks for watching. If you like my videos, fucking subscribe.